see. What can I tell you? I am Maeve McCaffrey. This is Corin Booty. We're going to crush it. That's what I can tell you. We are about to crush it. So you came to work. I came to work. I want you to be challenged. I want you to also be safe. So you're going to use your own intelligence and intuition to make this work for you. And I trust that you have that in you. I know you do. So if something doesn't work, you do something else. We're going to have some fun with some yoga blocks today. You know how I love using yoga blocks. If you have them, you'll use them. If you have like a little platform and it's not a yoga block, that's also great. If for any reason it doesn't feel good, you don't use it. That's the deal. And then we're going to use some dumbbells. I'm going to put my foot right up on top of that yoga block. And then I'm going to step back. Lunge it back. Bring it back up. Here is a very important part of lunges that you should be aware of. Both of your knees need to bend. When that back foot hits, drop down. You decide how big that drop is. And so when we have our foot elevated, that front foot, we're giving ourselves the ability to actually drop deeper than we normally would, but that might not work for you. And I already gave you that spiel, so you know the deal. Find what works. Take it back, we're gonna pulse it back right here. Pulse, pulse. Heavy front foot. Yeah, catching with his hip. Last eight. Four, three, two, bring it off carefully. Yes, yes. You don't have to flip around. I just like to have my leg facing you. I was about to say my working leg, but that's not true because they're both working legs. All right, take it back, take it back. Second side. Come on. I took an arrow to the heart. I never kissed a mouth that tastes like yours. Strawberry. Two more like that. One more, one more, one more. Take it back. Repulse. Go. Yes. Woo! Yes, Dee Dee, let's do this. Four, three, two. Beautiful. We have a squat. We have a little rotation. Check out my feet. So when I turn right, my left heel is lifting. Oh, when I turn left, my right heel is lifting. So good. Wrap me up between your legs and arms. Ooh, I can get enough. You know you could tear me apart. Beautiful. Put me back together and take my heart. I never thought that I could love this heart. Ooh, I can get enough. Two more each side. I want to be that guy. I want to kiss you. perfect. Just drop. Yeah. Little burnout. Bring it all the way up. Drop it down. Woo! Last four. Hold it up. Weights down. Beautiful work. If you have a mini band, we're going to use it now. If you don't, you're going to do exactly what we're doing without it. Lower legs, carefully put it on. Belly in. So it's back and on an angle. Good, Valerie. Beautiful. So hip extension. If you're doing this without a band, you're not pushing into any resistance, but you can create it. Beautiful. Take one leg back. Take one leg back. It doesn't matter which one. Shift a little bit into the front leg. Bring it in. Push back. So standing leg, that hip is stabilizing like crazy. This moving leg, you're pushing, hip extension, bam. Glutes. If you haven't figured out, I'm a big fan of like actually physically feeling your muscles when they're working. Beautiful, all one side and then we'll switch. So I often do this sandwich thing where I know my abs are working and I know my butt's working. You're gonna take it back, you're gonna hold it back. Little lift. Eight more, go eight, seven. Four, three, two, beautiful. Both sides working, y'all, right? Second side, we take it back and in. So this leg is just as important. This glute, glutes, this hip, just as important as the one that's moving. Possibly more important, here's why. Without this stability, whatever we're doing with that moving leg is going to be like not as great. So this hip stabilizing, these abs stabilizing, give freedom to your other leg to move. Making the movement better, making the quality of what you're receiving from that movement better. Stay in it. Take your leg back, hold it back. Lift. So nice. So nice. Woo, eight more, go. Eight. Beautiful. You're gonna slide that band above your knees to your thighs if it feels okay. You're gonna take your feet as wide as it feels comfortable with the band. We don't want the knees to collapse in. We don't want the knees to collapse in. Sit into a little mini squat, like a bar stool kind of height, and then the knees go out. We're not dropping them in, we're just going out. If you feel good here, after you've gone out a number of times, you can play with just a little bit of internal rotation. Bam. Which means knees do go in. But if it doesn't feel good, my feet are stable and strong. I own the ground under me. Beautiful. Keep going. I'm just going to turn sideways. Good. Hold it out. Pick up your right heel. Right knee only. Right knee only. Heel is up, knee only. Maybe we sit a little deeper. I think we do. Stay in it strong. Stand it up. Sit it back down. Left heel lifts. Knee. So good. Hi, little. Come on. Hi, little mister. Hello. Say hi. He's got dance moves like you've never seen. Did you come for Janet? I think you did. Oh my goodness, we're almost out. Two. Beautiful, stand it up. All right, my darlings. Mini band, I'm sorry, mini ball, if you have it, take the band off. Mini band can come off. Here comes the fun, mister. Shoulder blades, legs out straight. Press your heels down, hands behind your head. It's lift, lift, lift. Again, go eight, four, three, two, full range of motion side to side, we cross. So think about taking your shoulder up and across toward your hip. Control the extension, that down part. Strong legs, glutes squeezing just enough to keep you stable and not flopping all over the place, right? But not clenching. Come through center, soles of the feet come together, knees open out. Get a nice stretch here, a little pause. Shorten belly button to pubic bone, shorten belly button to sternum. If it's okay, reach forward. If it's not, support the head. Lift, lift. So based on the fascial connections in your body, it's really hard to get your hip flexors out of the equation when you're working rectus abdominals. They're supposed to work. They do some work. This position, legs out straight, you kind of minimize it a little bit, a little bit. Last eight, go eight. Four, three, two, release it. Off the ball. Off of the ball. Left knee bent, foot is flat. Right leg extends out, hands back behind the head. Keep the torso down to start. Tap into your center. Push the left foot down, so left hip is working. Push your right heel down, wake up the right glute, so both glutes are working, and then you'll lift your leg about knee high and down. If it feels good, you can have a little external rotation on that right leg, or it can be neutral. So your spine is not imprinted in the ground because our shoulders and our head are down, so we're working neutral spine. Use your exhale to empty the belly and to lift the leg. So you're lifting that leg from your center. Again. Make your leg longer. Make it even longer. Again, for four. And three. The only thing that changes is we're going to add the upper body to it. If you don't need it, leave it off. Let's go. You're going to crunch. Now your spine imprints. And if it feels good when you come down, you can neutralize the spine. So you don't have to stay imprinted. If that's better for you, do it. Try not to let that left knee fall open. Hold it up, hold it up. Cross, extend. So right knee, left shoulder toward each other. Yes, yes. Two more. Beautiful. Bring that foot down, head and shoulders back down. Extend your left leg out straight. We set it up. Take your time here. Don't need to rush into it. Push both feet down. Feel your glutes kick in. Neutral spine. Open up your chest. So see if you can stay broad here. Inhale. Exhale. Push and lift. If you like a little external rotation on the leg, go for it. If you like neutral, stay there. You can kind of play with it. Notice that right knee. Try not to let it fall out to the right. Connect your breath to this movement. Four more like that. Only thing that's gonna change, we're adding the upper body. You got this. Let's go. Last four. Hold it up. Bend the knee. We're going to cross. Let's go. Cross. Extend. Equal pressure in that right foot. So notice like the triangulation of the foot. Base of the big toe, base of the pinky toe, center of the heel. That's going to help control that right knee from collapsing in or collapsing out. I only said collapsing out because that's the tendency for most people, but for you, maybe you feel like the knee is dropping in. Try to keep that knee centered. It matters. If you think I'm nitpicking, everything matters. Nothing in our bodies is superfluous. Nothing. Almost out. Four. Three. Last one. Give yourself a squeeze. So, so good. If you have yoga blocks, we're going to use them. If you don't, you're fine on the ground, or if you want to use like a chair. If you want this to be even easier, use a wall or like a really elevated, sturdy piece of furniture, like a really heavy table or something, but nothing that's gonna move on you because we're going into a plank. Sorry, mister. He doesn't like planks. Like most, he doesn't like planks. Okay, hands are on your blocks or whatever it is you're using. And then we're gonna bring the right knee to your right elbow, over to your left elbow, back to right, step it back. Make sure you reset every time. Left knee, left elbow. Right elbow. Left elbow. Take it back. We're just gonna keep alternating here so that I don't have to keep barking out the instructions, which will get very tired for you, I'm sure. So it's wide, it's cross, it's back to wide, and then back. Keep going. Of course, you can do this on your knees. 100%, which is where the elevation really gets very handy because it makes it more accessible. Yes, 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 yes. I see you. I see you. You're amazing. I want you to like, that's your dialogue. I'm amazing. Mm-hmm. One more each way. Actually, wherever you are, you started on the right, finish on the left. And then stretch it back into a dog. Beautiful. Knees down. One block if you want. You're side lying. Block is on your knee. It's not that heavy. Well, let me qualify. If you're using a wood or a cork block, this is really stinking heavy. You might not make it the whole time. Good luck. From here, it's lift. So we're using the block, not as a weight, but as a tool to give us feedback on precision and control. Yes. Four, three, two, hold it up. Straighten out your leg. Oh, you might need to adjust it. I needed to adjust that. And then lift, lift. Oh, this guy wants to go down. This block wants to go down on me. It's not gonna happen. Last four, three, two, and one. Beautiful. Bring that leg around, sit up, and get a nice stretch on that hip. So kind of lift up, lengthen it out. Don't switch sides yet. Good. Hand or forearm. Side plank. Bring your arm overhead. Elbow, knee. You can have your bottom knee down. Of course you can. So nice. We are crushing Monday so far. Let's go. Last one. Fantastic. All right, switching sides for that fun with blocks. All right, set it up strong. Leg is up, kind of find where that block needs to be. I didn't say it on the first side, I know you know it, but this is a side plank with your hip down. So all that energy of the bottom rib cage lifting, it's still there. The strength of the shoulders there. Yes. Lengthen out your spine. So looking for as neutral of a spine as you can. You're gonna be in a little bit of a side bend here, but front to back, also think about, like, instead of like slumping here, what would be your neutral as far as like the curve in your low back, the extension through your heart, while there's a little side bend. And we're working to kind of take that side bend out by lifting the bottom ribs, but it's gonna be pretty hard fought to get totally neutral. Oh my goodness, you're gonna hold this one up. You're gonna extend the leg, adjust your block, or take it off if you need to. I have a feeling for me this side's gonna be a little harder. If you have very thin legs, this is gonna be super hard to keep that block on. I've got pretty meaty legs. It's in my favor for this exercise. I say that and I'm already losing the block, but that has less to do with the meatiness and more to do with it. This is really stinking hard on this side for me. Woo! 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring that leg around. Less of a twist, more about getting to this outer hip. Oh my gosh, that was like one big cramp on my hip for me. My left side, my left hip, I had an injury easily 3 years ago where like my hip, my leg got pushed in to internal rotation. I felt this weird pop and I was like, well, that's not good. And ever since then, it's leaps and bounds better, but it's always been a little weaker and it's been a little like testy in some of those things. Good, come up, side plank, find your plank first. And it's one of those things that I really have to be aware of and be kind to my body. And I think we all have those things, right? My point in saying that, let's go. Knee in, is that we can always work with stuff, right? Should never stop us. We modify, we skip. We do something in lieu of something that doesn't work. It doesn't have to cripple our ability to do. By the way, this is it. Come on, come on. Woo! Beautiful. Come around into a wide leg forward fold. Such good work. Lengthen your spine. I made the mistake of kissing Little Mister with lip gloss and sweat on me, and I'm just a furry mess now. Off to one side. It was totally worth it, Mister. I would do it again. To the other side. You don't have to be this low. You can be wherever it feels good. Come back to center. Walk your feet in toward each other. Bend one knee, straighten the other leg. Switch it. Bend both knees. Roll up your spine. Take your hands behind your head. Lift your chest. Open up your heart. Breath in. And then release it out. You are amazing. Again, I'm Maeve McCaffrey. I'm so glad you're here.